morning. It's actually 2:20 p.m. And the reason I'm vlogging this late is because I literally spent all of yesterday evening, well, not all of it, but some of yesterday evening and most of today morning, finally editing my vlogs. Holy shit, that was, like, those were a lot of vlogs that I had to edit. And I'm uploading as we speak right now, too. Okay, there were 16 vlogs. Yeah, wow. 2 weeks of vlogs, or a little bit over 2 weeks of vlogs that needed some editing. Yeah, I've just been so busy and stuff, but finally back on track. And guess what? I got something crazy in the mail yesterday. Well, counted as today, but I got something crazy in the mail, which will definitely make my vlogging experience so much better and so much easier. Do you want to know what it is? Do you? Are you ready? Are you excited? I'm excited. Alrighty. Do you know what time it is? It's time to open up what came in the mail. Actually, it didn't come in the mail. I actually picked it up yesterday. But it was supposed to come in the mail. But that's what we're going to open up. Let's do it. Alrighty. Let's open this box up. Got my box cutter right here. Oh, don't even need the box cutter because there's a place to rip it open from. See what came. I gotta say, these are one of like the most properly packed boxes I've ever seen. And bam! My new MacBook Pro. So excited. Oh, you guys have like absolutely no idea how excited I am for this, because like, it's my first MacBook Pro since 2009. I've been rocking my old one since 2009. I have no idea how the hell I got by for like seven years of using that. I got that in, 2009. I didn't have a proper laptop before that, like when I started university, like since 2007. So 2007, 2008, and a bit of 2009, I used to use this. What did I have? I wasn't really using a laptop at that moment. I was just using like the home desktop. And then I had a laptop while I was working at London Drugs. I got like one of those HP tablet laptops where you can like flip it around, put it down, and it comes with a pen. You could use it for writing and stuff. And I used that. And I kid you not, within the year and a half that I had that laptop, I must have sent it out for repairs about like 7-8 times. Like something would always happen. It would either overheat or it would just shut down. And yeah, but there were some good cool features on there, like the fingerprint scanner. Yeah, there was a fingerprint scanner on that in 2007. And the reason why it was awesome is because it would just, you know, like save all my passwords and stuff. And like every time I need to log on to somewhere, I would just use a fingerprint scanner. So it was freaking awesome. But again, it's not about all the features. It's about how it works together. And in 2009, when I got my MacBook Pro, my first one, I kid you not, since then, I've really never had any issues. I had some issues in 2010, was it? When I went to New York and my laptop stopped working. Luckily enough, had AppleCare on it. Actually, I didn't have AppleCare. I just had like that 1 year warranty that it comes with. Went to the Apple store. They fixed it right up. Put a brand new hard drive in because my hard drive cropped it. So yeah, good job, Apple. So far, so good. Using an iMac at home. And I don't use Adobe Premiere, so which is why I couldn't just get a regular like laptop, because a laptop would have been easily same features, it would have been half the price. Like this is one that's been modded up for like $4,800 or $4,900. I know it's expensive, but it's for work now, so I really, really do need it. So anyways, I'm gonna stop talking and let's open this up. I'm just gonna leave that thing running and I'll edit it after. Okay, that didn't even cut it. I just don't want to destroy the box. Even though I'm not gonna keep the box, but I don't like destroying boxes. Just in case you have to return it, you know? I don't want to give them something that's all ripped up and they're gonna be like, yeah, you know what? This thing is too damaged. Sorry, you can't return it. Even though I have absolutely no intention of returning this whatsoever. But just in case. Yes, I am one of those type of people that keeps their boxes for certain things forever. I don't know who messaged me, but I am sorry. I cannot talk to you right now. Oh, okay. I'm going to Snapchat this, actually. The new love of my life has arrived. Can't wait to open up this bad boy. Yeah, and I'm vlogging it. Okay, let's open this up. Put this knife away, so I don't want to damage anything else that's around here. So excited. Oh my god. It is so light. Well, it's not actually not. It's actually not that light, but it's so much thinner. I'm going to show you my
previous 15 inch.
This is my previous 15 inch. Look at the size difference. Like, seriously. It's like 1/3 of it. Oh my god. And it's like so much lighter. And this I thought was so durable. Like, this feels even more durable. So, like, oh my god. Again, I'm having a moment here. Having a techie moment. Techie moment. Put this to the side. Luckily enough for me, I already bought the laptop sleeve before the laptop came, because I wanted to make sure my laptop is going to be pretty safe. There's just something about opening up new boxes. This is why I'm an Amazon Prime addict. So yeah, as I said, something just about opening up new boxes that makes you feel so content. Well, I'm pretty sure the laptop's dead because I haven't been charged. So I'm just gonna put it on charge now. Oh, no, yeah, no, it turned on and it tells me that I have to charge it. Which is fine. The keyboard feels a bit different because it is different. It's a butterfly keyboard, so there's not much of a depth when you push the buttons down. So that's something that I'm going to have to get used to. And I kid you not, I'm not a big fan of change. So anytime I have to get used to something, it's like when I got my phone, right? Like, as I said, I've been a Samsung Note user for like a long time, and I wasn't happy with the whole Note 7 situation. So for the fact that I have to like get a different one, or get a different I had to get a different phone altogether. I had to get the Google Pixel. I kid you not, I was not impressed whatsoever. I was actually very devastated. But again, sometimes there's not much you can do, so I had to stick with what I got. But I kid you not, now I'm so like, I've adapted to it so well that it's not even a big issue using it. The reason I'm taking my time with this is because I want to take everything off so slowly, so nicely, just in case you gotta return it. You do not want to return a broken package or anything like that. So put this back. MacBook Pro, got like 2 stickers as usual, even though I've never used those stickers on anything. Force touchpad, Thunderbolt, blah blah. Comes with a weird smell. I don't even know why I smelled it. I think I smelled it because I've seen other people smell it, so I was like, okay, why not? Might as well smell it myself. Okay, put this back. So, one thing everybody's been like, you know, having issues with is this whole USB-C situation. Honestly, doesn't bother me because I've been using USB-C when I had the Samsung Note 7, and I have been using USB-C on my Galaxy Pixel as well. So it's not that big of an issue for me. I just got a bunch of cables that go from USB-C to USB-C and USB-C to USB-A. Honestly, I already carry cables as it is with me. So it's not that big of a deal. I don't know why people always make it a big deal, but whatever. One thing I did is that I know that they don't give you that long cable cord that comes with your wall adapter. So I ended up buying it on Amazon already in advance for me and my sister, just because, trust me, having a long charging cable is beneficial. Like, really beneficial. So, only costs like, what? Smells weird too. Just feels really plasticky. Ew. Bought this one for, I think it was like $18, including shipment. So it's not too bad. I don't know. This thing feels weird. There's like white powder stuff on it. So, where's my paper towel? I know they sometimes coat these things with like
some powder stuff. I don't know why they do that, but I know they do sometimes. So, anyways, wiped it off. Still feels a little weird, but it's okay. Take this off. Put this on. Bam. Perfect fit. Now, one of the best features that I think I actually personally like is the fact that you can charge your laptop from any USB-C ports. So there are four ports on this. So usually I would always have an issue because usually, and this happened all the time, I would always have, you know, the plug on this right side, but I would have to take it, put it around, go on the left side because I don't like it going over my keyboard. But now I can charge from any port at all. And it's charging. Haha. Oh, my baby is starting up. Got an iMac there, late 2013 or early 2014. And a 2016 laptop. Hands are a little powdery because of the cord or whatever. But English anyway. Is the main language. Press the return key. Weird having this little thingy here, but you know, cool. Anyways, I'm gonna set this up and then I'll show you some stuff after. So now I'm just waiting for this to update, and I'm copying all my folders from, or sorry, all my music from the iTunes folder to my hard drive. I'm gonna plug this into here, upload it on there, and this is just my 17 inch. My 15 inch is just not doing anything. And I'm watching Mr. Amin Panesar's music review on Ellie Mungert's new track, Chopper. Let's see what he says. So I'm at home, just planning on going to see Roshan, because he's back from med school as well. Okay, I got Amin Longia's Snapchat, and it's hilarious, actually. She sends me pretty funny Snapchats. So cute. She's totally like just going all out. She's like, I am totally broke, but I still went shopping and this is what I bought. Honestly, Amin, if you're watching this, her Snapchats are freaking hilarious. Anyways, I'm planning on going to see Roshan right now. I was supposed to be at their house at 8 o'clock, but it's about 8:40 right now. I'm a little late. Why? Because I'm backing up like my important documents and my important files onto my portable hard drive. And then I'm going to transfer that to my new laptop. So I'm taking my new laptop with me because I'm going to show them my new laptop as well. And because I know my parents are gonna sit there for a couple hours, I'm like, might as well get some work done. And I was supposed to meet up with a client to give their wedding video today, but my client unfortunately says, hey, can we meet tomorrow instead? Anyways, as you can see, I kind of shaved. I just felt like going for the clean look, so you know. Anyways, it says less than a minute for transferring. I'm gonna pack my stuff and let's go and see Roshan. And then we're gonna see Ravi most likely tomorrow. Yeah, I'm gonna see Ravi tomorrow.
Damn, it's so cold. Like, my windows on the side are like all frozen.
Good. Okay, exactly. What do you want to say?
So, before every Caribbean Airlines flight, they make two or three announcements.
You should tell the blog about your iPad facts.
Yes, they make two or three announcements. Anyone who has a Galaxy Note 7, please see the flight attendants for safety of them and everyone. They said like three times. Please go see security. If you have passengers,
stands up. Is iPad okay?
The camera loves you.
It's okay, Roshan. I gave my Note 7 back.
Dude, watch your vlog blow up, man.
I had two. Yeah. Oh my god, it's like super cold. I'm just leaving my cousin's house. Spent about good 20-25 minutes we're playing NHL. On his PS3, and I kind of sucked at it. I used to be the bomb at playing NHL when I was younger, but I haven't played video games properly in like the last few years, so kind of suck at it. And then we played Call of Duty, and then Call of Duty is pretty fun, even though it was like an old Call of Duty. Like, I'm talking about like 2009, 2010 Call of Duty, but it was pretty fun. But pretty good evening. Also, while I was at my cousin's house, I brought my laptop because finally it's light enough and slim enough that I can just carry it in a backpack, no problem. And on top of that, what you call it, it was really quick into like loading the information on. I know like all the important files that I needed on my hard drive, like I put on my portable hard drive, was like
I think 300 gigs, and that took about like 2.5 hours at home or 3 hours at home. And to put it onto the laptop only took an hour. And this is like just a USB 3.0 with the converter plugged into the laptop. So my laptop did a pretty good job, actually. Yeah, to be very honest, it did a pretty good job.